this time on frameworks running on Yocto. So for those of you that haven't encountered Yocto yet, it's kind of like a meta distribution or distribution generator. So one level of interaction more. It's a fairly flexible, very powerful system, very steep learning curve, but it's fairly popular with people doing very good projects, like industrial machine control panels, medical devices, cars, that kind of stuff. It can be used to create actual device images that go into that device. It can create packages so you can do online updates, or you can build the entire SDKs to do software development against your own custom device. And in Linux, Qt is kind of the go-to toolkit for touching line. So Frameworks 5 kind of naturally fits in there, especially the long tire frameworks that you could use in a regular environment. So the idea was, let's make this easily usable for people using Yocto by providing Frameworks 5 receipts in Yocto, so it's basically usable as easily as to do this. That's actually an effort that goes long time back. A couple of years ago, Johan Thelin started this in first 5 days. And that's someone's fault, and the course needs a lot of work, to revise that effort. And so we have a couple of possible meta layers, so it's basically a set of package definitions for framework sign posted in the KDE infrastructure. And there's a few things that we encountered that might be interesting for you working on frameworks. Because essentially what you do with Yocto is cross-compilation. Because your device usually is some other platform, ARM or something like that. And in order to support that, the Yocto system basically has two sets of builds, one for your host platform, where you build the compiler and all the build tools you need, and one for target, so that's the stuff that goes to the device, and that you typically can't actually execute on your host. And that can be a problem, as for stuff we build for the host system, we obviously try to minimize that as fast as possible. In particular, it means not putting in the external and the entire graphics stack just because your code generator depends on Qt doing. And that required a few adjustments in frameworks in the places where we have code this. Most of the time, this is just adding a build system option so that you can build the code generator without all the other dependencies. So just use core to do the solids checking, trying to run the generator or whatever it is, enables us to use this even if the entire framework depends on the graphics stack. So if you have code generators in your framework, you might want to consider those points, minimize that as far as possible. Don't depend on the graphics stack. Avoid runtime dependencies, like plugins in the code generator that is super annoying to support. A package is kind of my favorite offender there. We still haven't figured that out completely yet. And if you have just simple stuff to generate, yes, scripting languages like Python that is available on the host anyway. And it's CMake, which you can also use to generate basic stuff without ever needing any special support for this kind of cross-compilation. Another thing we looked at is how can we make that sustainable with 12 framework releases every year. And the most important part there is don't have patches against upstream. That might sound obvious, but if you look at the usual Yocto receipts, even those of Qt that are maintained by Qt, most of them have patches in some form to work around some cross-compilation issues. With 548, so 1 month ago, we finally got to the point where we had not a single patch against upstream anymore. Which means upgrading to the next framework series is as easy as running a script that is the version of us doing test build and hopefully nothing wrong. But it's no longer important updating patches and any of that. But how do we actually demonstrate that that we have frameworks for Yocto now, right? Because essentially it's just a bunch of libraries. We don't actually see anything, and we can't actually test if it's working. So what we did as well is package some part of Plasma. In particular, the Plasma Mobile shell following the same ideas. So we have a nice showcase. Hopefully looking up here. Showing the Plasma Mobile shell starting here on a Raspberry Pi 3. And that's the test case and the proof of concept. It's currently still using SDKM with text in the startup, so it takes a second, but there it is. Thank you.